Peace. This is King Noble, Black Supremacy. And with this particular video, I want to talk about Facebook and mainstream social media as identification, as virtual identification, containment, and behavioral modification being really the purpose of mainstream social media platforms. Let's talk about Facebook, let's talk about Twitter, and let's talk about YouTube. These are mainstream social media platforms. Now, the goal and focus of them, and I'm sure a lot of other ones, if they're not independently or privately owned and managed, pretty much function in a similar way. But I'll deal with the mainstream ones because those are the ones people have a problem getting off. I'll throw Instagram in there as well. Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook.
In this open air lab, chimpanzees are free to come and go as they please.
And this is
a human.
This is a human.
If they decide to stay, they participate in cognitively enriching tasks designed to mimic foraging behavior. When the chimpanzees are interested in participating, they enter one of Skylab's specially designed computer booths where a camera uses facial recognition software to recognize them and select a test based on that particular chimp's current familiarity with the task. Each trial takes about as long as it would for a chimp to forage a single bite, and each morsel of food they get is accounted for in their diet.
Do the doors open when they approach? No human even needs to be...
No, nothing.
So what is for us a great way to collect data is for them an experience similar in many ways to what they would be doing in the wild.
People have trouble leaving them. The other social media networks that are private or even black owned, like www.kingnobleblacksupremacy.com, don't really hold their attention. They're not very active over there. They don't even understand the purpose of having a social media platform account. They don't even understand the genuine purpose of networking on social media. They've forgotten because they've been trained by Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram. So this is where they got their training. So this is where their mind was basically crystallized as to what social media is used for and what the purpose is. So how they approach it is limited to what they was initially exposed to, which really is a program. Facebook for sure is a social media behavioral modification game. It has nothing to do with social networking at all. It has nothing to do with expressing your ideas or your opinions or what you think. Nothing to do with that. They want to identify you, contain you, and then modify your behavior. That's the whole purpose of it. What you wanted to do on social media is network, meet people. You want to be authentic, change people's ideas, be creative, express your uniqueness, interface with different variations of human existence. You want to experience the diversity that is human consciousness around the world. That's your purpose. But these social media platforms have basically limited that. They're not created for that. That's not their purpose. First, they want to identify you. So you're snitching on yourself. They're using all your information to identify you, categorize you by what you do, put you in a particular box, determine what you like and what you don't like and what threat you may or may not be. Then once they identify you, they want to, once they identify and categorize you, they want to contain you. So they want you to only, they want to put you with people that think like you so that your ideas will not get outside of that network, get outside of that group of people. So you're being contained, you're being quarantined. If you try to friend people outside of your network and try to grow rapidly and expose your ideas to a larger audience of people, then that's when you see how contained you are. They start saying it's spam, and they start blocking you and disabling your actions and your abilities on there. They start suspending you once your content is reaching an audience outside of where you're supposed to be contained and quarantined. So they want to contain you and quarantine you, keep you within the group. So it's not for you to expand and reach more people and possibly change the world. It's meant for you to lock you within a particular group and keep your ideas there. So people that pretty much already know what you're talking about, already feel how you feel, won't be the only ones that will be exposed to your ideas based upon their programming and their algorithm. Then, past containment and quarantining, they have something where the behavioral modification piece. That's when they're training you that if you really want to grow and meet more people, and you want to grow your network and reach out and get beyond the prison, the quarantined or the containment unit called your network or your friends or the group of people that you know, if you want to start growing beyond that, then you have to modify your behavior. So you modify your behavior by them showing you what is likable as far as what's the post. What's okay to post, what's okay to put up, what's going to get a lot of likes. These are things that are allowed. This is what is permissible. This is what is acceptable. What's going to gain a lot of likes. So they teach you what is likable and what is dislikable, because it's a reward system. If you post something that is consistent with the mass of consciousness, with those who are programmed and those who accept the programming, then you get a lot of likes. So you're getting reward. If you post something that is not liked by a lot of people, then, or is disliked by a lot of people, then you get suspended. So now they're training you on what to do, what is likable and what is unlikable. Not about what you want to express, not about what is authentic, not about what is real, not what is valuable, not what captures a real moment, but what is likable and what is unlikable. So now this messes with your dopamine and serotonin.
New research aimed at understanding the impact of social media on adolescent brains is already showing fascinating results. The National Institutes of Health study is following more than 11,000 children over a decade. In early testing, researchers found significant differences in brain chemistry for kids who had at least 7 hours of screen time a day compared to kids who use screens less. Anderson Cooper spoke to the researchers for last night's 60 Minutes.
Until recently, it was impossible to see what happens inside a young brain when a person is focused on a mobile device.
Look.
But now, scientists at the University of California, San Diego, have hacked that problem.
How often do you have young people come in for the MRIs?
So as often as we possibly can.
Dr. Kara Baggett is an investigator on that $300 million NIH study. Her team is scanning teenagers' brains as they follow Instagram, the most popular social media app. When we met 18-year-old Roxy Schimpf, she was about to participate in Dr. Baggett's study.
How much time do you actually spend on screens?
I check my phone pretty regularly, I'd say.
What's pretty regular?
Every at least 10 to 20 minutes.
Is that a conservative estimate?
Probably.
She can't take her phone into the MRI because of the powerful magnets in the machine. So a mirror has been placed above her face to allow her to look across the room at a movie screen displaying images from her Instagram account. This way, Dr. Baggett can see exactly which parts of the brain's reward system are most active while using social media.
So you can actually see a part of the brain light up when you're feeling good?
Yes, in the scanner.
In the scanner?
Yeah.
Based on her data and the results from other studies, Dr. Baggett is among scientists who believe screen time stimulates the release of the brain chemical dopamine, which has a pivotal role in cravings and desire.
So you're more likely to act impulsively and use social media compulsively instead of like checking yourself.
you want to keep on it to keep getting
the good feelings.
Psychologist and best-selling author Lisa DeMore is a CBS News contributor and is here with more on this. Lisa, good morning.
Good morning.
So we won't know the full results from this study for quite a while, but does anything concern you from what we see thus far?
Well, here's what we do know. We do know that social media is incredibly compelling. We know that it triggers the reward centers in the brain, and this is true for grown-ups too, not just teenagers and kids. So we know that.
Because every time you hit the like button, so every time somebody hit the like button, you feel appreciated, and then dopamine is being released in your brain, so you get a good feeling, like a drug. If something is unliked, or you get suspended, or lose your account, or get some function disabled, then you're upset, you're depressed. So it behooves you, when you get back on there, to not do things that's going to not give you the reward of dopamine by being liked, and to do things that are likable. So you think you are trying to express your uniqueness, you think you're trying to be creative, and you think you're trying to network, but you're actually playing a game that's actually programming you to behave in a certain manner online. Because if you don't behave in that manner, then you're not going to be able to keep your account. You're going to get disabled. You're going to have certain functions and features disabled. So you're learning, now they're teaching you through this behavioral modification system what is likable and what is unlikable in virtual reality. Now this is training your brain on what it can be rewarded for and what it can be punished for through this virtual game that you're calling Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, whatever. So now that's going to go over into your real world, because consciousness is everything. So they're training you in a virtual reality how to ultimately function in the real world, because you're going to take this virtual brain function, the way they train your brain, you're going to take this brain training into your real life, because you can't turn it off. Your brain is going to be locked into this particular way of functioning. So when you go out into the real world, you're still going to be functioning the same way. So they're just not limiting you on Facebook. They're limiting you based on how they are modifying how your brain operates. You are literally being trained like a monkey. If a monkey do this, he get the banana. If the monkey do this, he don't get nothing. If you do that, if you post what everybody is going to like, then you get a whole bunch of likes. You feel good. You keep your account. You grow your network. They show more of your content. You don't post what people like, then you get your account suspended. You get certain features disabled. So you get a bad feeling. So most people are going to want to go with the good feeling. Like a video game, you want to win the video game. You want to make some progress in a video game. But any real video gamer know that you cannot make any new progress in a video game, that you can't do anything new in a video game. Everything that you can do has already been programmed. So you're not going nowhere new in a video game. You're going just where you can go. You can only make it to the levels and into the places where you're supposed to go based on how that game was created and invented. Well, Facebook is the same thing. You just think you can be more creative. You can be more unique. You can express more you, more your ideas. No, you can't. You won't grow that way. You only grow if you model your activities off of what has already been defined as likable, what has been defined as acceptable, what has been already put into motion as a good online behavior. What the people like, and it's not what people like, it's what they have been trained to like. The same program programmed them to like certain things and to dislike certain things. So you only can fit, you're only relevant within the likable region of Facebook. That's where your relevance comes from. Not your uniqueness, not coming to know you as a person, no respect for your particular humanity or your worldview or your perspective. None of that's really relevant. And if you try to make that too relevant, then they will lock you within a small, contained, and quarantined group of people that you call your friends and your network online. If you want to get out of that, then you have to allow your behavior to be modified so that you can do what is considered likable to grow. But you're actually sacrificing your authenticity and the real you and what you may believe and what you may think and what you may really want to express. You're going to sacrifice that so you can get the dopamine reward of doing what is likable online. So then when you see people posting a lot of the same things on social media, then that doesn't come off strange to you? That doesn't really expose the social media matrix that people just keep posting the same thing? Because that stuff, it has been, is considered likable. That stuff has been certified as likable. So to be online and to have value and relevant and merit and to grow your network and to be able to really move online, you have to be certified likable. If you're certified unlikable, you won't make no progress. You won't grow your network. You'll be shadow banned. You'll be suspended. So Facebook is programming you. It's a behavioral modification program that's modifying your behavior, modifying you, and modifying your consciousness. It's interactive behavioral modification. So it gives you the impression that, hey, you're free, I'm posting what I want, how I feel today, but you're not. That's not what you're doing. You either gonna play the game as it was meant to be created, or you get kicked out of the game, or your profile or your character inside of the game will die and your account will not exist anymore. So it's not so bad that you might lose your account. That ain't the worst part of it. The worst part of is losing yourself once you modify your behavior in a way to be successful online, to be something in virtual reality, to the point where you actually kill the real you, your authenticity dies. And now who you become in real life is really the profile person and walking around on the streets. You become your Facebook profile, you become your Instagram profile, you become your YouTube profile. We thought that we were creating Facebook profiles. We didn't know that the Facebook profiles is really creating us. We're being created by the profile. We've been created by our interaction with this artificial intelligence. We're being created by it. And we're being rewarded, and we're having a biochemical relationship, and our brains are adapting, thus our behavior is changing. What I'm saying is, Facebook and mainstream social media is an artificially intelligent way of policing. It is like a correctional, it's a true correctional facility. It's a virtual correctional facility because it makes you correct your behavior because you want to do what is likable. You don't want to be banned. And you are actually volunteering with this censorship. You are volunteering to be censored. Whereas in a prison, somebody's locking you up, forcing you in there, telling you to shut up, locking you down for so many hours. But when you get on Facebook, you're volunteering to comply, to follow these particular rules. That if you follow those rules, they're going to definitively modify your behavior and make you biochemical addiction to the reward system that they have created inside of the game. So now human consciousness is being shaped by artificial intelligence under the auspices of networking, under the auspices of expressing themselves online. You're not free online because you're censored. You're not free to post what you want. If you want to be on there, you're limited to their reality. See, this artificial intelligence and social media could shut you down in a way that nobody in real life can shut you down. Somebody in real life could tell you to shut up, I don't agree with you, and you're gonna be ready to fight. But social media can make you agree to censor yourself in order to function on within that virtual reality that you can self-censor just so that you can be you can operate within this acceptable realm. So you can feel accepted within this artificial reality where so many people are at. And they all have been, their behavior has been modified as well. So you are accepting this. You are voluntarily censoring yourself and allowing your behavior to be modified, and you are biochemically becoming attached to the stimulus within that virtual reality. So now you won't be able to unplug. And now you are actually a prisoner within their virtual reality. You're actually trapped within their virtual world. And you can't get out. You cannot escape. If you try to get out, you're going to feel withdrawal symptoms, depressions, disconnected, isolated, out the loop, to the point where it has become your complete reality. The travesty of this is that the real purpose of networking or being online is lost completely. So you won't come over to a website that may not have 100 million people on it, but you can authentically grow as an individual. You can authentically post your information, post your ideas, and connect with people in a real way. You can't connect with people in a real way on Facebook because they limit who you could connect to and also limit what you can post and what you can present and what is acceptable based on somebody else's mind and based on somebody else's mentality, based on some consensus reality that has nothing to do with you. But I want to touch on that. And that's why it's so important to join www.kingdomofblacksupremacy.com, because you're literally escaping from the mainstream behavioral modification prison. You should be getting online to grow, to evolve, to learn, and to express yourself fully and connect with those authentically who express themselves fully and exchange based on authenticity. But you won't be able to do that on Facebook. You won't be able to do that on Instagram. You won't be able to do that on Twitter. And you won't be able to do that on YouTube. Because if they can control what you can post, if they can control what you can say and what you can think, they can control where you can go and what you can do and where it would evolve to. This is a reality. This is a reality. I had to go in on that. This is King Noble Black Supremacy. Join my website, www.kingnobleblacksupremacy.com. Donate, don't hate.